Once upon a time, $10,000 was a great deal of money for someone to spend buying into a poker tournament. It was also the largest sum of money someone could invest in a poker tournament, even if they wanted to play for more, as no casino had yet dared to attempt a higher buy-in. But the super high roller tournaments of today make one thing clear. 10K tournaments are just child's play for broke asses. The escalation of stakes is really no surprise to anyone that's observed the poker industry over the last decade. The WPT got the ball rolling in season one when they announced that their championship event would have a $25,000 buy-in, the highest no-limit entrance fee at the time. In season nine, the WPT and the Bellagio got together to hold the first ever $100,000 event on US soil. Eric Seidel won the event, obviously. But in 2011, that was a foregone conclusion before the event started. This year, they upped the ante by making it a re-entry event.
We gotta re-enter.
Allowing players to bust and buy back in for another 100,000.
One time wasn't enough.
Also known as four chips. Casinos and poker tours are always in competition to draw the most eyes and entrants to their events. The best pros are always lusting for higher stakes so they can win all the money faster. And the ultra-rich are rarely given the opportunity to play for a sum that's only semi-irrelevant. The edge businessmen like Bill Klein and Daniel Perper have in these events is that at the end of the day, their financial state remains constant. Winning or losing will change nothing about their lifestyle, which can almost never be said for any professional poker player and a super high roller. But what is surprising about these astronomical events is the consistent level of interest. The first time such an event was attempted was at the Aussie Millions in 2009, and it drew 23 players. Now in 2012, there are four events of such a buy-in around the world, and all of them are getting at least three tables of players only a year after Black Friday evaporated a great deal of money in the poker economy.
You know, life is short, go for the gusto. If you can afford it, I say, take a shot at it and go for it.
Because of their size, events of this buy-in usually don't generate a first prize all that higher than a usual 10K tournament. But what they do create is an incredible bubble moment. Our unfortunate bubble boy in this tournament was Justin Bonomo, who missed out on over $250,000 by busting in sixth. It's common for play around the bubble or a substantial pay increase to be altered by the real money implications of being the next to bust.
Because people are gonna be sitting back, hoping to get into money.
But rarely is the bubble itself for an amount of money that could buy a house or five houses in Vegas.